jokaista peliä lähdetään niin kuin huolellisesti valmistautuen voittaa, että se on ainoa keino, että tässä sarjassa vaan pitää niin kuin koko ajan siihen tulevaan vastustajaakin niin kuin laittaa eforttia ja katsoa, että jos sieltä löytyy jotain asioita ja löytyykin, mihin itse iskee tai mitä pitää varoa.
Yeah, I think as a whole, the responsibilities between myself and Tema, we're working together in the planning and the execution of the training and matches. Each of us has a little bit different area of focus. For example, during the week with the training, I'm running the training and kind of overseeing the training. And on match day, he's doing the team talk and the preparations on the actual day of the match. But all the while, during the match, during the training, we're communicating and working together in all those scenarios. The big thing is it's not just one area. We each have responsibilities, but we're supporting and working with each other as well as the other coaches on staff. On our match days, it's important for me. I am spending time myself and Risto getting the players warm up and mentally ready on the pitch. The big thing is to have them ready to go so that when the referee blows the whistle, we're there.
Ennen kickoffia tulee vastustajan kokoonpano, että ennen sitä on jo tietyt pohjat niinku tehty sitä ottelua varten, ja sitten kun tulee vastustajan kokoonpano, niin sen pohjalta sitten tehdään ne lopulliset niinku päätökset, lopulliset sitten linjanvedot.
During the match, I do a lot of the analysis and evaluating the match as it's going on. We speak about any possible changes, if we need to adjust players or make substitutions. You know, the big thing for us is making sure that not only do we have like plan A, but we have plan B and plan C to adjust to what the opponent does. It's not just on match day, but it's in the build-up to the matches. You go through various scenarios so that when you're faced with something like that, it's not the first time you're thinking about it, you know, in the 85th minute of a match. You've at least thought about it prior to the situation happening. Yeah, well, I think after the first two home matches, you know, when we, regardless of the score, I mean, it was 0-3, but the reality of it is the performance, I think, is the biggest thing. And when you're dealing with professional players, there's a certain standard and expectations from themselves and each other and the coaching staff. And when you have to step back and take a look and say, were we performing at our best? And the answer was no, and that goes for all of us, players, coaches, staff, everybody around. We weren't able to put together the performance that we wanted on the pitch.
No totta kai aina kun pelit ei kulje, varsinkin se, että me pelattiin myös todella huonosti siinä, että ei ollut, että pelattiin varsin hyvin ja hävittiin, vaan että me, kyllä ne oli niin kuin huonoja pelejä meiltä, niin totta kai se sitten kaiken näköistä semmoista epävarmuutta ja yleistä mielipahaa niin kuin tulee ilmoille siinä, että se semmoinen tietty epävarmuus ja semmoinen oma tekemiseen oli varmaan niin kuin se kopissa se semmoinen yleinen mielipide siinä.
The spirit of the players was a little bit down because nobody likes to lose and nobody likes to lose at home.
No, SJK-peli tietysti alku oli vähän semmoista tunnustelua, pelattiin vähän uudella tavalla, että miten se homma lähtee siitä käyntiin. Kapteeni Patronen loukkaantui siihen heti 10 minuutin jälkeen. Taas toi vähän semmoista epävarmuutta siihen.
Mun rooli tipahti siitä keskikentältä sit yhden askeleen alemmas ja sillä lailla ikävä tietysti, että kun kapteeni tipahtaa pois rosterista, niin se on iso isku, mutta itse olen kuitenkin pelannut talven verran topparitonttia, että se oli silleen ihan okei, ja Tuukan kanssa meni oikeastaan ihan hyvin.
Varsin hyvin, niin kuin jokainen usko siihen niin kuin meidän pelisuunnitelmaan, ja siihen vaikka jouduttiin vähän vaihtaa ja meni vähän uusiksi pakka, niin uskottiin siihen omaan tekemiseen ja se lähti rullaa siinä sitten.
We had the free kick, which was just outside their box. Sake Matala stepped up and hit the free kick. It was curled over the wall and into the corner, which was great strike. You know, to give us the lead that early in the match, there was a huge boost of confidence.
Ensimmäinen maali on niinku helpotus. Ei sillä, että mä olisin maalin tekijä, mutta tavallaan, että pystyy auttamaan joukkoa, että siihen mentiin johtoasemaan kotistadionilla, ja tavallaan siihen purkautui myös vähän semmoinen niinku oma turhautuminen, mitä on ollut omista peleistä ja meidän joukkueen peleistä, että noissa paikoissa on joskus itse uralla tehnyt ennenkin, että se oli aika luottavainen fiilis, että sen saa klaarattua. Ja se oli hieno fiilis kyllä, niin kun kävi vähän huudattaa Kingeenkin sen jälkeen, niin varmaan näkyy, että vähän purkaantui turhautuminen siinä.
Päästiin ylivoimalle, vastustaja pääsi vähän varkain siitä ainoasta paikastaan sitten tasoittamaan. Ja sitten me oltiin hetken aikaa siinä vähän ihmeissäänkin kentällä, että niin kuin mitä tässä tapahtuu, Esiko rupesi painaa päälle.
Esiko's goal, if you look at the build up from it, the initial ball came from one of our long openings. They won the second ball and just kind of put it forward. You know, for us there's a couple things to learn from is, you know, with our long openings we have to be in the better position to win the first ball and the second ball. And then if they do win the second ball, we have to be a little bit stronger and more physical in those areas. But again, if you look in Senioki, that happened. Following match, they didn't have any chances like that. Plus side is the players took the learning experience against Senioki to give up a goal that way, to not be able to give up any of those chances against Mariehamn. And then, you know, our second goal, which came late, they fouled. And one of the things I have to say, I got to give credit to Mosa. You know, he recognized that all of Sanayoki dropped inside the 16, so he played a quick 1-2 to get the ball back, so he was able to carry it an extra few meters forward. I mean, it was like 10, 12, 15 meters forward to then get a better angle to serve the ball into the box. And, you know, when he put the ball in the danger area, Sokka was able to get on the end of it and nod it home. But, you know, what led to it was Sanayoki having two fouls. You know, those fouls came from us playing well and moving the ball. But again, it's one of those things that, you know, we were fortunate enough to, when we did have the set pieces, to take advantage of it. And two goals off of two set pieces, that's great. I would say this, you know, our current position on the table, it's 5 matches played. As we say in English, don't put the cart in front of the horse. Let us go one day at a time, one match at a time, and build from there. If we're doing our job properly, the results will come. And, you know, at the end of the day, it only matters where you end up on the table after the last match. So, again, for us, the next focus is just on the following match. As much as we like to look at the table and say, hey, we're here, we're here, we're here, for me as a coach, it's about what we're doing on the pitch. You know, our performance against the next opponent, our performance against the next opponent. And as long as we keep guys focused on that, that's the key. If we get too caught up in looking at the table, you know, the one thing about Vikosliga, if you win 2 matches, you can be in the top 3. If you lose 2 matches, you can be in the bottom 3. So again, the biggest thing is about staying focused and doing the daily work and preparing for the next opponent. That's how I look at it.